Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Pastor Patrick, your most favorite brother from an alternative mother. Hope you guys are all doing all right. This is Resurrection Day, aka Sunday, the first day of the week. Praise God when our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ was resurrected. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters, for the Word of God tells us in the Gospels that our Lord was resurrected on the first day of the week. So, by the grace of God, hallelujah, every week on the first day of the week, we remember and remind ourselves what he did, what the Lord has done for us, hallelujah. For Jesus is the Lord. He reigns forevermore. Jesus is the Lord who reigns forevermore. Hallelujah, praise God. Hallelujah, blessed be the name of the Lord. God Most High, hallelujah. The name of the Lord is a strong tower, brothers and sisters. The righteous run into him and they are saved. Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. I'm just celebrating the goodness of the Lord. For the Lord is good and his love endures forevermore. Hallelujah. He is blessed and mighty and wonderful and worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, I just want you to pray with me right now. Let's worship the Lord. Let's honor the Lord. You know, the Bible says to enter his gates with thanksgiving in your heart and enter his courts with praise. Hallelujah, Lord God. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Father. Hallelujah, Father. Thou art worthy of all praise and all glory. Hallelujah, Lord God. You deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands in worship as we lift your holy name. You deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands in worship as we bless your holy name. For you are great. You do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. For you are great. You do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. For you are great, you do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. You can just go on and on and on, brothers and sisters. That's what invites the presence of the Lord. As the Bible says, the Spirit of the Lord inhabits the praises of his people. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. God is good all the time. Hallelujah. He is an awesome God. Hallelujah. So that's what I'm trying to show you, brothers and sisters. I try to teach you guys. You know, it's to worship him and seek his face. Only will I seek, as the Bible tells us. And as King David said, your face only will I seek. Hallelujah. Seeking out the Lord. You know, people always talk about, you know, they have about personal relationship with the Lord, all those old denominational people. They try to evangelize people and tell them, oh, you need to have a personal relationship with the Lord. But by that, they mean just saying the sinner's prayer and living like hell the rest of their life. They're talking about they're going to go to heaven. Or when you talk to them and say, tell me about, you know, oh, you're a Christian. They'll say, I'm whatever. They'll say the denomination as an example, Baptist. Oh, I'm Bible Baptist. I'm Southern Baptist, whatever. Oh, okay. Well, tell me, you know, let's talk about the Lord. Well, let me tell you about our church bake sale. Let me tell you about our church a picnic, or we have a men's fellowship, or we have a women's fellowship, or we have, you know, this, that, and other, what our church did. Instead of talking about, look what the Lord has done. Hallelujah. What has the Lord done? Hallelujah. What's God doing? What's God doing in your church? What's God's doing in your life? What's God's doing around you that you saw God doing? Hallelujah. Not about what people have done, but look what the Lord has done. Hallelujah. Look what the Lord has done. Hallelujah. He healed my body. He saved my mind. You know, I can never remember the words of that song. He healed my body. Because I've only heard it once or twice. He healed my body. He say, He changed my mind, maybe. He saved me just in time. I'm going to praise his name. Each day is just the same. Hallelujah. Look what the Lord has done. Hallelujah. He's awesome. He's an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. You know, you got to praise him. You got to mean it. You got to sing it. You know, brothers and sisters, I've said this a long time ago. You know, when I visited lots and lots of churches, many churches I've been into, brothers and sisters, they can sing the Spirit-filled songs, but they're an old dead church, you know. It's not the song. People say, oh, that's a great song. No, it's not, you know, it's not the song only, but the singer of the songs too, brothers and sisters. When you feel the presence of God, it's that singer's relationship with the Lord, plus that song. Of course, if you're singing a worldly song or something, of course. Most nearly every Christian song was inspired by God, and that song has a move of God that goes with it, brothers and sisters. I could do a teaching on that, and I need to. I think I have way back. But every move of God has music that goes with it. Like the songs that Charles Wesley wrote, the brother of John Wesley, wrote many great songs. One of them, most people know, Hark the Herald Angels Sing, you know, for Christmas. Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn king. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. See, the songs that are honoring the Lord that are filled with the Spirit also usually have the Word of God in them and the salvation message in there. God and sinners reconciled, joyful all ye nations rise, for the triumph of the skies with angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. That's an awesome song. It's an awesome song. I could sing it all day long. It's awesome. It's an anointed song. It's ordained by God to be written, even though people associate it with Christmas. But you can celebrate the birth of Christ every day. It's not just once a year. As a matter of fact, just FYI, we don't know when the Lord was born. A lot of times they say September, October. We don't know. Could have been born any time. We do not know the day the Lord was born. It was not December 25th. But anyway, brothers and sisters, it doesn't matter. We were celebrating the virgin birth of Christ with that song. Hallelujah. God and sinners reconciled. Hallelujah. While he laid his glory by. What is that? I started singing it now. Those other stanzas of it, they're all really good. They're not so familiar. While he laid his glory by. I don't want to have to edit the video. I guess I might have to. Anyway, brothers and sisters, praise God Almighty. Hallelujah. God is good all the time. That's an easy one. I can't remember those. A lot of those older songs are very complicated too. God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good. God is good all the time. Evil sinners, so unworthy, but for us he chose to die. He filled us with his Holy Spirit so we could stand and testify. God is good. God is good all the time. Hallelujah. Praise God. He is worthy. He is worthy to be praised, brothers and sisters. That's what it's all about. You know, to worship the Lord. Hallelujah. I still can't remember the rest of those words. But another song that Charles Wesley wrote, it's called Oh for a Thousand Tongues to Sing. I've only heard it once or twice also. For a thousand tongues to sing my great Redeemer praise. 'Tis music in the sinner's ear, the triumph of the age. Hallelujah. 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 Praise God Almighty. He is worthy. Hallelujah. Help me to proclaim the glories of his righteousness, the triumph of the age. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord from on high. The name of the Lord is, what is it? It's a strong tower. The righteous run in to him and they are saved. It's also Bible verses, brothers and sisters. Praise God Almighty. Praise God. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. Let's look at some Bible verses right now. Let's look at the Word of God. Excuse me. To get my Bible. Let's look at the Word of God. Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty. He is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Listen to this, brothers and sisters. Psalm 127, starting at verse 1. Except the Lord build the house, they that labor in vain that build it. Except the Lord keep the city, the watchman waketh but in vain. It is vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late, to eat the bread of sorrows, for so he giveth his beloved sleep. Brothers and sisters, blessed be the name of the Lord God for his word. Let's pray for the word of the Lord. Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you for your Holy Spirit. We thank you for the praise and worship, Lord God, the song that you would put us in our heart, that you put in our heart, Lord God. We thank you, Lord, for you told us in your word that we should sing hymns and songs of worship unto you from our heart, Lord. You said to give thanks with a grateful heart. Father, we worship you in the name of Jesus. Amen. I just can't help but praise him, brothers and sisters. Sing, you know, I want you to worship the Lord. It's just in my spirit that we need to thank him. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ, his Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Because of what the Lord has done for us, give thanks. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters, hallelujah. Except the Lord build the house, they that labor in vain that build it. Except the Lord keep the city, the watchman waketh, but in vain. It is vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late, to eat the bread of sorrows, for so he giveth his beloved sleep. Brothers and sisters, apart from the Lord, we can do nothing. That's another way of saying that, what the Lord Jesus Christ told us in John chapter 15. He said, I am the true vine, ye are the branches. Abide in me that I might abide in you. For apart from me, you can do nothing. He said that every branch, you know, my father is the husbandman or the farmer, and he prunes every branch. That's our chastisement. Those are the valleys that we go through. Even the valleys, the valley is higher ground. Hallelujah. Satan can't touch me where God's love abounds. Hallelujah. That's another song. Hallelujah. Even the valleys are higher ground. Hallelujah. In Christ, hallelujah, we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. With God, all things are possible. If God be for us, who can be against us? Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. As the Lord said in Matthew chapter 11 also, all these Bible verses I'm quoting, what else the Lord said in Matthew chapter 11? He says, come unto me, all ye who are burdened and heavy laden, and I will give you rest for your souls. For my burden is easy and my yoke is light. Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. For the yoke of the Lord is light. It's not a heavy burden like they dealt with under the law of Moses. Praise God Almighty, the Lord has given us a better covenant. As the book of Hebrews tells us, he's given us a light burden. Hallelujah. Praise God to be yoked with the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The King of Kings and Lord of Lords, the author and finisher of our faith, our high priest and apostle, the Bible tells us, as I read from the Word of God Friday night on the video I made then. He is our high priest and apostle. Hallelujah. Praise God for the Lord Jesus Christ. And the Lord said, as I'm reading to you or quoting to you here from John chapter 15, the father is the husbandman and the farmer, and he prunes those vines that they may bear more fruit. And Jesus went on to say, any branch that does not bear fruit will be hewn down and cast into. It's good for nothing but the fire. Brothers and sisters, these things ought not be for us. The Lord cursed the fig tree. Mark chapter 11. Why? Because it didn't bear fruit. And that was done in symbolism of Israel. That's why Jesus, when he told the parable of the vineyard, and he said there was a man that owned a vineyard. And when it was harvest time, he sent his servants, a servant there to get the harvest. And the servants who were running the vineyard, they beat up the servant and sent him away. So he sent more servants, and they beat them up, even killed some. So then he said, I'll send my son. They will honor my son. And then when they saw the son, they said, hey, this is the heir. Let's kill him. And they killed that son. And then the Lord said, according to his parable, what do you think the owner of that vineyard will do to those who killed his son and rejected all of his other servants, beat them up and killed some of them too? Then the Pharisees said to him, oh, he will take that vineyard from them and give them to another people who will give him the harvest and do his will, bear fruit for him. And Jesus then said, have you not read in the scripture, the stone that the builders rejected has become the head of the corner, or the capstone, or the cornerstone. This is God's doing, and it was marvelous in our eyes. Then his disciples said to him, hey, don't you know that the Pharisees know you were talking about them? And of course the Lord knew that they knew he was talking about them. Brothers and sisters, Israel became a barren people and refused to do the will of God, refused to bear fruit for God. And they rejected. That's why Jesus went to them on Palm Sunday, as Jesus said, I must first be rejected by this generation. They turned him over to Pontius Pilate to be killed. And Jesus said, when he went in on Palm Sunday, he said, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, how I have longed to gather you as a mother hen gathers her chicks, but you would not. And you will not see me again until you say, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Even as the little children were yelling that day, Hosanna to the Son of David, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. And that Hosanna to the Son of David is a Greek word, victory, meaning that he would be the conquering King of Kings, the deliverer, the Messiah. That's what they thought the Messiah was going to do the first time, was to deliver them. They didn't understand the scripture because their eyes were closed and didn't understand that he would be the suffering servant. Isaiah 52 and 53, that he would be the crucified Messiah, that he would not even break a bruised reed, and that his voice would not be heard crying out in public. That he would be, you know, as it says in that text from Isaiah 52 and 53, says he was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And by his stripes, we were healed. We are healed. In the New Testament, we were healed. 2 Peter 2:24, or 1 Peter 2:24. By his stripes, we were healed. But for them, before, written by Isaiah about 700 years before Jesus was born, by his stripes we are healed. He was bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. Hallelujah, praise God Almighty. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. That's what the Lord has done for us. And so except the Lord build the house, just like he built the house of Israel, and they rejected him. They built that temple. King Solomon built that temple. Moses built the tabernacle in the wilderness. All as the Lord had inspired them and led them to do. So that's why we read in that psalm that King David is telling us, except the Lord is the one to build the house. Those that labor, labor in vain. Your watchmen, you talk about watchmen, watching. They wake up people to alert them that there's some attack coming. It's in vain. Because if God's not protecting the city, they're going to be wiped out anyway. It's useless. Talking about in the natural and in the spiritual here, brothers and sisters. So you can have a church. There's plenty of churches. Tons of churches. You know, the famous quote of the Chinese persecuted Christian who came to America. That's the famous quote of what he said. He'd been in prison there and all this stuff. And as a matter of fact, I believe Watchman Nee is probably the one who said it. He said it's so amazing what all the American church has been able to accomplish without God. And it's true, brothers and sisters. We have all these dead denominations, all of these churches built not by the Holy Spirit, but by might and power of mankind. The opposite of the Bible verse from when in Nehemiah and Zechariah, what the prophet was speaking in the time of Nehemiah when they're rebuilding the wall and rebuilding the temple after the Babylonian captivity. The word of the Lord was, it's not by might nor by power. Tell Zerubbabel that I said, God told Zechariah to tell Zerubbabel, it's not by might nor by power, but by my spirit. But with the Laodicean church and the American church in particular, and the Western church in particular, it's in reverse. It's not by God, it's not by his spirit, but by might and power of man that things get done. That's the problem with, and America is becoming more and more true, brothers and sisters, as you know. If you've tried to go, you know how many people tell me every day. I know myself because I've done it myself. Even a long time ago, in the year 2000, 2001, 2002, in particular when I first started out, I still go visit churches. But I really went all over the place seeking churches. And I would say 1% or 2% of churches are spirit-filled places that reflect what the Bible says the church should be. Probably 2%, you know, 2 out of 100. And that was way back. It's probably a whole lot worse now, brothers and sisters. So accept the Lord, build the house, those that labor in vain. So the same thing is true with people's family life. You know, if your marriage is not built on the rock, even as Jesus talked about the man, you know, individual. At the end of the Sermon on the Mount, the Lord's talking about, be ye perfect, therefore, as your heavenly Father is perfect. And he goes through all those things. It's really the magnum opus. Of the call of God, the high calling of God in someone's life, the Sermon on the Mount, Matthew chapter 5, 6, and 7, where Jesus starts out with the Beatitudes, as people call them. You know, blessed are the poor in spirit. You know, blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. You know, that's a Bible verse the Lord had given me just maybe 6 months ago about revival. I was praying to the Lord for revival, and the Lord spoke to me that Bible verse. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. So that's when I begin to pray, Lord, give me more hunger for righteousness and thirst for righteousness. See, all things come from God, except the Lord build the man. You labor in vain. That's what the Lord says at the end of the Sermon on the Mount. He says, those who hear my sayings, listen to me, all you denominational, once saved, always saved people. Jesus said, the man who hears my sayings and keeps them, like James said, I believe it's, is it first James chapter 1, verse 22 or 2:22? I can't remember every single Bible verse all the time, brothers and sisters. But by the grace of God, James said, you know, don't be a hearer of the word only, but a doer. You know, because a man who's only a hearer of the word and not a doer is like a man, likened unto a man who looks at himself in a mirror. King James says in a glass, it's a mirror. And then he's beholding himself and then he just, you know, he walks away. He's not doing those things. You know, so the Bible is like a mirror. It should reflect to look at ourselves in light of the Word of God. So Jesus said, the man that hears my word and doeth it, James says, to be a doer of the word, not hearer only. To be a doer of the word. Jesus said, the man who hears my sayings and doeth them is likened unto a man who built his house on a rock. And when the storm came, and the wind blows and the water is, you know, the waves of the water hitting against it, the house would stand. It's built on the rock. Who is the rock? Rock of ages, sing to thee. Let me hide myself in thee. Jesus is the rock of ages. Rock of ages. That's a different song. Jesus is the rock. Rock of ages. Jesus is the rock. He is the rock. He is the rock. It's a good song too. The newer one, Rock of Ages, in the old song, the old hymnal song, Rock of Ages. That's Yeshua, HaMashiach, Jesus the Christ. And then Jesus went on to say, the man who hears my saying and does not do them is likened unto a man who builds his house in the sand. So when the waves come and the storm comes and the wind blows, Americans, you all know that story of the three little pigs, you know, and the big bad wolf. That house that's built of stone, built on the rock, the wolf can't blow it down, the devil can't blow it down.
house that's made on the rock and built of rock and on the rock. Hallelujah, Jesus Christ. It's a man who hears the word and keepeth it is as a man who built his house on a rock. Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty. As this is an old hymnal song that I really like, and I think it's a Presbyterian hymnal from way back. It's called Christ the Solid Rock. That's another song about the Lord being the rock. It says, and I love the main word out of that song is this stanza from the chorus. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. Hallelujah. That's anointed. You feel the Spirit of God? That's an old song. That's an old hymnal, hundreds of years old. I think. I don't know the date it was written. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. I used to know, I've heard it a few times, and I can't remember all the stanzas of it now. When he shall come with trumpet sounds, then may I be in him be found, for in his righteousness alone. I can't remember. It's only in his righteousness alone. Hallelujah. I can't remember all the words, brothers and sisters. As you can probably tell, I'm making this video late on Saturday night because I'm going to be busy tomorrow, and I want to get this video done for you, brothers and sisters, and not be late making it tomorrow. So praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. He is the rock. He is the rock. Rock of ages. Jesus is the rock. Hallelujah. You know, I'm going to be in Rock Hill. Just mention that. I'll be down in Rock Hill seeing people June the 4th. Have a meeting on the night of June the 3rd. I'd already have a group of people, and I don't have permission to invite any more people because of somebody's house. Then Saturday at 1 p.m., I'll have a meeting at somebody else's house in the Charlotte area, and I don't have permission to invite other people unless I hear from them. And then so after 4 p.m., I'll be free to meet individuals one-on-one, or, you know, if you bring somebody with you, that's fine too. 4 p.m. until Saturday, June the 4th, I will be at a hotel between Rock Hill and Charlotte. And I've got to make my reservation in the exact spot, but if you will email me, neartochrist@aol.com, I will give you the location. You let me know. We can text. Usually before, I let people, just show up. That's fine, too, but it's nice if you're, we can text and make sure, I try to have it where I can try to kind of schedule people, If people want to wait, that's fine, and somebody else is finished. But some people are coming from a far away. I give them priority. People, the farther away someone's coming, maybe they have a schedule. They have to leave at a certain time. Other people say, hey, I can stay. As it goes, brothers and sisters, I'm open to try to be and I'm always trying to be as flexible as possible to meet with as many people as I can. Some people need to be baptized. Some people to be baptized in the Holy Spirit. Some people want to try to get a word from the Lord, etc., to be prayed with. Some people want to, ask questions about the Bible, etc., personal problems, etc. It's up to the Lord. God bless you all. You know that I love you all, brothers and sisters. I want to pray with you some more. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, Father, I just praise your holy name tonight, Lord God. Father, you are awesome in this place, Lord God. We thank you, Lord, for your Holy Spirit. We thank you for your grace and your mercy, your loving kindness and your steadfast love. My Lord and my God, you are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What a Savior. Hallelujah. What a friend. Healing, loving. Hallelujah, Lord God. You are with us until the end. Praise your righteous name, Lord God. You are righteous and holy and worthy, Lord God. We praise you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Right now, I decree and declare healing. Healing for all who listen to this video, who are watching this video. I decree and declare physical, mental, and spiritual healing right now in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. I declare the word of the Lord in your ear. He is the rock of your salvation. He is the deliverer. He is the redeemer. Hallelujah. Build your house on a rock. Be a hearer of the word and a doer of the word, not a hearer only. And walk away from what you've heard. But be ye a doer of the word. Don't show your faith by just what you hear. Even as James said, you show me your faith without works, but I show you my faith by my works. Hallelujah. Don't you know, O vain man, faith without works is dead. Hallelujah. Even as the book of James in the Bible tells us. Father, we praise you in the name of Jesus. James chapter 2. And Father, we honor you and we praise you right now, Father, in the name of Jesus. God bless you all, brothers and sisters. Love you all in the Lord. And by His grace, we will build our house on the rock. And that He is the one who's building the house. Except the Lord build the house, those that labor in vain. Brothers and sisters, unless the Lord is the one and we are working with the Lord and doing His will, it's all in vain, brothers and sisters. It's all in vain without the Lord in our lives. Hallelujah. God bless you all. May the peace of God be with you all. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.